Petra? You think I can clean my guitar with a baby wipe?
You can try.
Okay. Well, let's clean it. Let's clean it. It's cleaning it with a baby wipe.
Okay, okay.
Cleaning it with a baby wipe, buddies.
It shrunk! Oh no!
What's up with that, buddies? Hop in, babe, we're going!
Woohoo!
Well, your new friends from the Netherlands used to have a house left into the mouth. Got an old RV for Penelope, she's a 1983. Taking pictures and patterns of design. Penelope loves rock until the end of time. Well, RVlicious, if you like a vibe, please subscribe. Please subscribe.
I'm gonna try and open it. Coconut. Here's your coconut. I'm wearing my gloves so I won't get hurt again. Yes, so that won't happen again. First you open one of the eyes. There are three eyes and usually one is soft enough to open right away. Just open a hole and then once you have opened it, let out the coconut water. So, that's all the water. Taste the water. Yeah. If it's too salty or has a weird smell, but if it's sweet, then it's usually good to crack open. If you're in a store and you want a ripe, good coconut, you have to make sure that it's dark brown. And when you shake it, you should hear the juice, the coconut water inside. You should hear it splash. If you hear it splash and it's a dark brown coconut, it should be a-okay. The next step is to crack open the coconut. You need a hammer, the coconut, and what you do, there are seams on the nut, and those seams are the weakest spot of the nut. So
if you don't have a hammer, you can use a rock on a deserted island.
Also, yes, you can hit the coconut on the rock. Same effect. What you do is you go round with the hammer, like so. Ah, wow, this one is cracked already. You see? There it is. Whoa.
Yep.
Casualty. Whoops. Easy peasy. That's how you break open a coconut.
Wow, that was super easy. This is unedited, buddies.
Unedited? And yeah, wow.
And nice coconuts.
Why, thank you. So that's how you open a coconut. Now, the matter of getting the meat out. Coconut meat. Sharp.
It's a pocket knife.
Take out your pocket knife.
Always bring a pocket knife to a deserted island.
Yep.
Or in a van.
Yep. What you do is you cut the meat like so. Mm-hmm. And then you cut it here to make a beginning. Oh. Oops, blooper. And you get it out like so. And then you can taste. Mm-hmm. It tastes good. Yummy. Mm.
For the extra quality check.
Mm-hmm. Yes?
Yep. Are you okay?
Awesome. Mm.
Then you continue.
Yeah, then you continue until the coconut is empty. Ah, but it's empty. And this is the meat that comes out of it. And now we can snack.
Mmm.
Mm, yummy. Mmm. What?
So what happened?
What happened?
Last night.
Oh, yes. We found a little baby bird lying in the grass. Oh, it was so cute. Here's a picture.
You left out some dramatic details.
Oh, yes, you nearly stepped on it. Luckily, I saw it in time and pushed Patrick away.
The saver of the baby birds.
Saver of baby birds, yay!
Yes, I mean, she used superhuman strength to do it, thereby saving the baby bird. It was a northern mockingbird.
Yes, we suspect.
And it was a fledgling, meaning it had feathers and all, covered in fluff. And sometimes, because this was a big, pretty big bird, pretty big baby bird, they get pushed out of the nest, or they are impatient to fly and they jump out of the nest. And then they just stay on the floor for a few days while the parent birds, supposedly, if they're good parents, they feed them when they're still lying in the grass helplessly. So it's always recommended not to pick them up and take them home or put them on the tree, because they'll just fall off again. And today we're going to check up on the baby bird.
Yes. I wonder if it's still there. Hmm.
Ooh. Where are we going?
See if we can find the baby bird. If it has not been blown away by the storm and grabbed up by predators or something.
You've been worrying about baby bird.
Yes.
He survived in the cold night.
Mm-hmm. Yes.
Let's go check up on him. And?
No baby bird yet.
But we're looking.
But we're looking, yes. It was somewhere in the grass. Maybe it already flew off. It's safe.
We didn't see any feathers.
Nope.
Then we checked the perimeter.
Yep. So I'm guessing it's safe.
Twinkling lights in a pink moon sky. Here I stand looking up, up high. I don't know where I am or where I'm going to. But for the night, I'm by your side under the velveteen sky. day's now hushed and out of sight. The darkness is just a blush away. As the earth spins my dreams away. So tonight, before tonight, I'm by your side under the velveteen skies. So take my hand and hold me tight. Be my love, be mine tonight. I am yours, let's slip away into the starry night.
We're going so rechts up, weg.
Right up road.
Right up road. Never heard of it before, but we'll see.
Your side under the velveteen sky. Under the velveteen sky. Under the velveteen sky.
For us. Let's plug into the power pole. Well, buddies, we have arrived in rechts op Wik.
Wallpaper,
huh? Yeah, that's me.
And you, Petra?
That's me, yes.
We got a mail from YouTube.
Ooh, that's nice.
Our Felicious, we always knew this day would come and we hope you did too.
Uh-huh.
Your channel just hit its first 1,000 subscribers.
Woohoo! Yes. Why, thank you, YouTube. Nice.
Oh, it's still going. See? The counter.
Yes. Bananas. We can show you around the camper spot. Oh, we parked a Penelope. On the edge of the camper spot. And there's Patrick getting out. And he's gonna inspect. With, you're gonna inspect if you parked correctly, right?
So there's a, yeah, this is perfect. Perfect. We left a bit of room.
Yes.
For our project.
Mm-hmm.
Working on the...
In case we want to do that.
There's a soccer field.
Soccer field, yep.
Over there.
Mm-hmm.
And of course, most importantly.
Yes, most importantly.
Powerball.
€1.
€1 for about 1.75 kilowatts.
It's turning around, buddies. Hope you can read it. Yeah. Yes. Yeah. I live in water.
Maybe it's free power too. Oh, hot water.
Hot water. Yeah.
Awesome. I can have a shower.
Awesome. Yes, and there's room for, I think, maybe...
10.
10?
I read 10.
10 spots?
10, maybe 15 even. No, 15.
Yeah. It's big. Yeah. But, also over there.
Yeah.
Ah, yes.
It's there, but...
it's huge, yes.
It's only... Is there one power ball?
I think so.
Two power balls.
There's a lovely bench. Here you can throw away your trash.
Ja, so, ja, müssen wir dann mal gucken, wenn wir mal wieder zu Hause sind. Wir müssen ja, muss mal so ein paar Stellen, dann müssen wir gemacht werden. Auch da drunter, dann, bevor er zu weit geht. Gut, dann nochmal lohnen, ist nur blöd, ich hab das so schön eingegipst. Scheiße. Aber muss man gucken.
Yesterday it was very quiet.
Julie, but I see that face, I know it's time to make Petra happy, happy camper again.
You're sitting in the shade of our camper. I mean, really? Other side, they can sit in the shade of their own camper. But hey, they're this close to the camper. I mean, jeez.
And to keep my meisje happy and my girlfriend happy.
Yeah. Oh.
So I did have a chat with them, approached it with a smile. We wouldn't do that. That's maybe that we're too polite, but we wouldn't go sit that close to somebody else's van.
Yep.
So now they got our power and our spot.
Yes.
She immediately said, I'll take your spot because we had the best spot.
That's probably what he wanted in the
park. Maybe, yeah, maybe that's what they want. Eh? Very foxy.
Yep. They are.
But I don't want to see Petra unhappy. I don't want to feel
crowded.
Yeah, grumpy about it. And then sometimes the best thing you can do is say goodbye with a smile.
Yep.
And just move on our merry way.
Adios.
We already saw most of the part of the village anyway.
Yeah.
For us it's just a day early that we leave.
Yes.
With new adventures.
Yes, buddies, we're going to our next destination called Westerhold. It's also in Germany. Yes, tiny building. Yes.
Ah, here it is, buddies. Ah, wow. Completely for ourselves.
Completely empty. With strong and everything. With power and everything.
Awesome. Huh. With a power pole. It's 1 euro.
Mm.
1 euro for 2000 kilowatts.
Nice.
1, 2, 3, 4, 6 pots at least. Another power pole. Is it a bin?
Beautiful.
Not been
completely empty.
And four more hookups. 12 hookups.
Wow. Hmm, not bad. Water. I one more.
Water. I think this is an upgrade from the loud elderly people, right? For the moment.
For the moment, yes.
Here we can do a nice little project.
Yeah.
Look at this smiley. So it's important to keep your van girl happy. What are we doing?
We're having an evening stroll.
Moon is up. Meanwhile, Betty's going to continue walking in the middle of the street. And see you.
We'll see you.
And there's Penelope. We got the whole area for ourselves.
Mm-hmm.
Some people say this is creepy, alone. But this is what we prefer. We prefer to have no neighbors. So we can finally get around to creating our musical masterpiece.
Yes, exactly.
We're already practicing.
Yep, that we are.
Coming soon.
Coming soon. Irish gate. Do you ever feel the same? Well, maybe we could change, turn the ship another way. Feel it in the darkness, we're sailing right into those jagged cliffs. Yeah. Some say we've always been insane. Hey, life's a foolish game. Mini tribute to our bestest patron, Rose. Simple equation, we're an enclosed system. Got the world gone missing, plus all our CO2 emissions equals degradation, wasting shifts and mass extinctions. Oh no.
We don't know what we're doing, British. Keep that in mind when you're watching these videos. We don't know what we're doing. But we're doing it anyway.
Encouraging to do it.
Now we have silveradoed up the van. Now the fun starts.
Let's hope so.
We've even dressed for the occasion.
Yes, I'm in my rosy outfit.
God don't work on commission. We make up one big breathing chain. We're quite the same. Hey, life's a foolish, foolish game. Same. Well, maybe we could change and turn the ship another way. Take less than we've been given if we move in that direction. Yeah.
Project Wallpaper, a success.
Yeah, life's a foolish, foolish game. Life's a foolish game. Hey, life's a foolish game. Life's a foolish game.
So we decided to continue the roses on the board. Oh, look at that.
That seems to glue. So. Wow. Let's see, let's do some overlap.
Very smart.
Centimeter?
Yes.
You think would be right?
Wow.
Ta-da!
Wow. You've made it round where the yes. Wheel thingies are.
We can put the carpet back.
Huh.
I jumped.
Oh. Yes, so now we have the wall of roses.
Mm-hmm.
It's now complete.
Yes.
And
just
this one.
Yeah, we need more rolls.
So we have the round the window downwards. That's the last final piece.
Yes. Open up. Ta-da. Nice and cozy.
What's our next project?
Replacing the curtains.
So now, if you like, want privacy in your window, but you want a bit more light. The lovely assistant roll up one of the curtains.
Exciting. Wow, very nice.
Hey, who's that? no spectators.
But.
Oh, that looks happy.
Yes, it does.
If we are fed up with looking at this,
yep,
we buy another tablecloth.
Yeah. Washable tablecloth. It's that easy. Only €5.
So to treat ourselves, we're going to make fruit smoothies.
Smoothies. We got exotic fruits, wine grapes, mandarins, melon, peach, and pineapple, mango and kiwi. A vegetable flavor on the rocks, a spinach, apple, pear, melon, and grapes.
We also have bananas.
So let's add some milk. Oat milk. Maybe it fits. Sort of, kind of. Start, here we go. And close your ears.
Ice cream. Hello.
Hello. What's the damage?
30 watts. So really? 3 smoothies, so 10 watts per smoothie. Including the cleaning.
Amazing.
With the water, the rinsing.
Yes.
So only 30 watts.
Amazing.
So now we know when we're on a power pole with €1 in the Netherlands.
Actually,
we can make unlimited smoothies.
Yes.